Assalamu alaikum, Sayyidi.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, when we read the ihda, does it also send the blessings to all those who are deceased from, also from our families?
Yeah, for all your loved ones and descendants, it sends a blessing to them, and if there's any particular people, then you can add that at the end. After the shaykh's names, you can add to your amma, your parents, abba, your abu, everyone. You can mention everyone, from your parents to your aunts, your uncles, your relatives, living and deceased, your children, and you just continue. But for in general, then it's the supreme souls, the soul of Prophet ﷺ, his Ahlul Bayt and holy companions, and the shaykhs inshaAllah is the sort of mandatory one. Then everyone can add their relatives, their parents, their relatives, their children, their families, everyone inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum, Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, I made the mistake of sharing your teachings in my own words and I feel my energy has been overtaken. Please forgive me for my bad adab and ignorance.
Allah bless you. That's the danger thing. Last week we talked about that, when somebody said that, why can't I just share and why can't I just, you know, do what I want, and we tried to give an example that there's a danger in which when you imitate something that is not at your level, you can be spiritually harmed, is another way of saying it, that people may be more observant over it. When a shaykh has an ijazah to teach, because the shaykh was unknown, his circle of teaching was very private and low-key, when an ijazah to go out and teach is an ijazah that as a target is put upon you, the higher level support, we will shield you. Because anyone who comes out into this satanic forum of this dunya and want to teach a haqqaiq and relate a haqqaiq, there's a bullseye on you. So the ijazah is a protection for them.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nurjan. Thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
That the shaykhs, and you read the ijazah, they're basically saying, any wise and any interaction that you do, we are supporting you. Means that our protection is with you. So anything that's coming, we're going to defend it inshaAllah for you and your loved ones, because not only they come after you, they'll come after every weak link which is your family and your loved ones. When you don't have an ijazah, then every time you post and say and speak, you're basically putting a bullseye on your head. Difficulty, hasad, hardship. So many difficulties can come on to a person, to their families, to their children, to their loved ones, because you put up something that is not you, and you put up a target that you're not prepared for that shield, and you direct the people towards you. As a result, their devils start saying, oh, this one. And beginning to attack, and attack that person, their family, their loved ones, and they're not fortified for that reality. And immediately they feel their energy drop, they think many things are happening in their homes and their family, because it's very real. You think that in a satanic world, putting out information against shaitan and talking about the haqqaiq of Sayyidina Muhammad is not going to be sort of an agitation. So it means the reality is such that before this, the da'wah and small da'wah to people that we know, we try to put out the articles of the shaykh and not make it seem like it's something from ourselves, but people whom wish to post, that can go out to thousands of people, reposted, reshared, re-put out, and now everybody's face and their devils face these people. And many difficulties, many hardships, and their lives are filled with hardships, and they don't know why they're filled with hardships. They think they're doing everything right, but this is the difficulty of that. Especially in days of difficulty when things become so much more and so much more satanic and dark. That's why it was very clear that just take the articles of the shaykh, post them. That's all. Don't put a bullseye on your head for no reason and upon yourself and your family, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
On this topic of the glass half full, how to deal in situations when others complain to us?
Yeah, try not to listen, we already have talks on that. On the energy talks, the meditation talks, so we've covered that many times. Don't listen to people who complain, don't be a source in which people want to defecate into your ear. So this is a horrific energy, so this is what shaitan is basically doing. Through a person is trying to find an ear in which to put every type of garbage and negative energy. So people are just waiting for an ear to talk to and complete download, download, download until that person can become sick again from all of that. So it means it's very real, this energy world. I don't know why people don't understand it, but it's a very real world. So you have to put like visuals to understand that everything is like somebody has an arrow, and as soon as somebody's talking to you, they're actually taking out and firing arrows at you. And then these energies come, so you basically have to train yourself, thank you, not interested, I don't want to listen to, you know, something that's not correct or just negativity, and you should think of it as positive, and don't, God forbid, don't be na shukr, and Allah will take everything away. So it means all of this is the tariqah teaching, but in these days even more so, very, very dangerous. That it just imagined every time people put out something there's a bullseye. That's why it's best just share the articles, share the videos. InshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Shaykh.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
How can we be more thankful through the difficulties and change our mindset from negative to positive?
By being thankful, and exactly like what we described, is you have to write down on a piece of paper, I can't imagine Allah open for me to be in the tariqah. You don't, if we don't understand what that is, that's a different problem. That we don't really understand what does this mean? To be in the tariqah, what does it mean that we're now been given keys to the heart of Prophet ﷺ? Well, talk to some other Muslims and none of them have that understanding, none of them even barely have a respect for this type of reality. So then you understand, oh then this is a big gift Allah's giving to me. When 90% of the Muslim community doesn't know the greatness of their own Prophet ﷺ, well that's a big gift. Then we start to appreciate what we do have. The job you have, it's a big gift in a world in which many people can't find any job. The food that you have is a big gift in a world in which many people have no food. The family that you have is a big gift in a world in which people have no family. The time you have with loved ones is a big gift because many people have no more time with family, they're gone. So every step of the way it can get a lot worse and it can go very fast. It was but one shout and overnight, what is it now, up to 7,000–8,000 buildings disappeared in Turkey. Entire families collapsed, 9-story, 10-story buildings, they're gone, finished. All the complaints in the world, it means nothing now. So our life is about being thankful to Allah. Don't let shaitan fool us and take our faith away, because every step of this is distancing us from Allah. And then we think we're doing this, we're doing that, nothing is opening. No, all these things are opening, we're just not thankful for it. And when we're thankful for it, we see, oh, it's so beautiful what He's given. That the zikr comes, the energies are there, these beatific understandings are all there, that's the garden. But people waiting for the zikr and thinking, oh, I hope that my du'a will come. And then they become angered, oh, my du'a didn't come. I said, but you came into the garden and but you didn't see the gardens. You were too concerned about the du'a that you wanted or the something you wanted that was going to open. So don't want anything and be happy with everything, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi, Shaykh.
Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
So is it okay to post quotes from your articles along with the article from a profile that intends to represent the Shaykh?
Yeah, don't represent our faith, our image and say Shaykh Nojan's page, just put out a Muhammadan way, Sufi meditation and make it an organizational page that promotes the Shaykh's articles, that here's Shaykh's article with a link and a synopsis of the article. That's not an attention to you because it's not your name anywhere on that. But when the person puts their own name, writes their own things, then they want to put a target on their head and their family, and here you go, because 20 people like it, 50 people like it, now 50 shaitans attached to those people are going to see if they can take you down so that you're not another one coming up. Have you seen like an army? If you start firing from a window, all the other side says, he's in the window over there. So you give your location away. So that's not the brightest thing to do in these types of difficult times. But to put out the Shaykh's articles, then they have to deal with the protection and the way that they're going to protect the Shaykh. And until they say for the Shaykh also, don't do it anymore, then you'll see everything go silent. But for now it just promote and keep yourself out of it, and you should be safer and better in the long run and achieve what you want to achieve from Allah, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Mawlana.
Wa alaykum as-salam.
How do we take an integrated approach of tariqah and the 12-step program? How can Islam and 12 steps fit together?
The 12 steps is designed by Islam. So anybody who's in the 12-step program and a step in which to recover and a path towards recovery, and if you read the 12 steps and read the tariqah teachings, you'll understand that these are inspired by awliya. Now they didn't have to get credit for it and give officially, oh, this tariqah did that. But Allah's grace and the reality of awliya put upon these inspirations and these teachings. So this is a immense blessing. From the heavens. on how to submit to a higher power, that's called Islam. So you people can understand energy and spirituality, you can understand that when you take away the words and the dogma and understand the concept, that's Islam. I accept the power higher than myself and my life is on how to submit to that power, and the things I can change and the things I cannot change. And then taking a daily inventory of oneself. We're very familiar with these things. This is Los Angeles and the Western world, that's everybody's familiar with these concepts. But it is inspired by the heavens. And if you understand them, you'll understand that it is Sufism, because you're continuously taking an inventory of ourselves. It's called muhasabah, an accounting. Every night everyone should be an accounting of themselves, and everyone is under the vice and the evilness of bad character. Yeah. So because they're under their bad character, they fall prey to all of these desires, and that's the danger of how to overcome those desires and these bad characteristics that destroy their humanity and destroy their ability to achieve what Allah wants them to achieve of realities, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam.
Does extreme weather affect jinn and unseen beings?
Affect them or… well, I don't know if it affects them, but I know that when they come it affects humans. So the weather and the winds and the lightning and the rains, it's their movement, it's electricity. So if something is an electricity being and it moves around and comes in large numbers, then you can imagine, yeah, there's going to be lightning, there's going to be hail, there's going to be storms. And so they can try to imitate that too by sending electrical currents in the air. But the greater reality is that the jinn kingdoms and their movement causes this. So a lot of times the wind, the storms, the rains, the hail is the movement of these tribes and these clans and their movement, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
In your last video you mentioned an event where Prophet was attacked with magic. Can you shed more light on the event?
We have to make reference to it and read from it if that's with the understanding. If you want this particular event, you can Google that when Prophet was attacked by black magic, and Sayyidina Jibreel came, and that was the revealing of the 11 times reciting the Surat al-Falaq. That to recite 11 times and blow, and that there was a string or a hair with 11 knots on it, and they were to recite 11 times to make that magic go. We have to refresh our memory by reading the actual event and the description of it. But the gist of it and the understanding of it is that Sayyidina Jibreel came and gave to Prophet the surah to recite and the number of recitation, so that people would have a dalil and an understanding that the surahs have a power, and their particular number in which to recite the surah has a power against this magic. So the numbers are quite important, and the understanding of the numbers are important in relieving oneself from their difficulties and from the magic that people cast upon people. And that again Prophet is an exemplar of the faith, that lending himself for this example so that people would understand, oh, if the Prophet of Allah is giving this permission and giving this understanding, then this is something that must be understood from the nation. And led many awliya to meditate and contemplate those realities and to understand sirr and black magic and energies and negative energies and how people are trying to use negative energies to affect people. inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Sayyidi, how can the youth try to build or practice for the be thankful for the half-empty glass mindset?
Yeah, I think it's just a constant reminder, that's why they're mentioning it tonight. Because if you look at the social media, you'll see that it's designed to be the half-empty. The fear of missing out, the posting of other people's foods and cars and places and vacations and what they achieved and their gatherings, everything. It's all designed by shaitan to make people feel like they're missing something. We described many times, so they can't eat at a restaurant because they looked at so many other people's pictures of restaurants, they say, oh, well, ours doesn't look like this. It's not even about the food, it's about somebody want to take a picture. They don't want to drive in their car because they saw the picture of somebody else's car. They don't understand their event because they look at somebody else's huge event. It's all this game that shaitan plays on people so that never they're happy with what they have. Because even that person is looking at somebody else's profile that's even larger, bigger, more. It doesn't end. Because he has them looking up. When you look up in life, just hurt your neck. But the tariqah is to look down, the don't look up, don't look to what people have, be thankful for what you have. And that keep your eyes on your feet and keep your feet on the path. So that's the danger now, we described many times, the youth don't want to even get jobs now, they just want to sit and play influencer. And take photos of, you know, food and the food that they, and even drive by other places, they don't even have to go into the restaurant. They just want to walk in and take a photo like they were eating there, right? You don't even have to sit there, they just walk in, take a photo of somebody's plate and post it as if they're sitting and eating there. Everything now is what from Dajjal? Dajjal means deceit, so it means everything now is a deception. So everybody plays in that deception. So how to come back and to hear that you have to be thankful for what you have is a great jihad, a great struggle where not too many people survive that struggle. That's why you begin to understand why those numbers were described when 6 out of 7 people will be taken off the face of this earth. Well, because the likelihood of them being thankful to Allah is probably very low. So as a result these difficulties and they enter themselves into these oceans of difficulty and that's the danger, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Is it okay to listen to other people to improve ourselves in ways other than spirituality? For example, mental health, physical health, making money, forgive me for my ignorance.
Sure. Yeah, if you think every professional has something to offer. So if somebody knows coding, yeah of course you have to listen to those people who know coding and those are dunya matters, it's not a problem. But never to listen to other people as far as spiritual matters because now you're going to have conflicting ideas. Oh, you know, like do like this, you'll be relieved of your sadness. Do like this and you'll be… And before you know it the people are starting to have conflicting, oh, I listened to a little bit of this, then I did a little bit of this. And that's the danger, is they start to go left and right to alleviate themselves. But for, you know, material and dunya matters and how to do math, how to do this, how to do write something, then alhamdulillah they have to educate themselves. So it's good to be educated. But in far as spirituality and spiritual practices, it's best to adhere to one way of teaching and one shaykh's way of teaching, inshaAllah. If there's knowledge there, if the shaykh has no knowledge then no. So it's like if he doesn't have any food, then you'll find his students are going everywhere because they're hungry. But if the shaykh is sufficiently feeding the students, then they're taking the knowledge they need. And that's why if there's two, three shaykhs are teaching, then they sit with their shaykh and get all the knowledge they need. But if the shaykh is not talking, not teaching, then of course then the only human necessity is they have to eat, they have to sit and seek knowledges. It's a requirement from Prophet ﷺ. So that is mandatory in Islam for people to seek knowledges. So as long as the shaykhs are teaching, then it's the requirement of the student to seek the knowledge, to read, to understand, to go deep into these realities. Allah.
As-salamu alaykum ya Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
SubhanAllah, alhamdulillah, from all the videos that we repost of your videos, 99% of the followers and people who like are non-Muslims. Shukran Sayyidi for all your guidance.
Yeah, mashallah, this is what we've known for 30 years. That the people who come to realities are shockingly not the people that most people would think. And that the people who you thought would come and be interested in programs and interested in zikrs and interested in all these things, no. So that's a, you know, is a isharat and a sign from Allah that the sun would rise from the west. So you'll find the Western audience that, you know, has done it all. They want to buy something new. They want to buy this religion, they want to get it and take it. And others are now selling their religion. So I think that one all the way out there, the Abrar, who made the house of competing Kaaba. Huh? What was his name? The Ashab al-Fil? Yeah, he made a competing Kaaba. Yeah. Now the new one is doing that too. He's coming making a competing Kaaba and designing a whole thing because they get hasad that why people are going for Allah. I can make something better like a cube. And I can make all these fantasy hotels inside and everything. I will make a huge tourism place, waterfalls, people can be naked, they can run around, they can do every kind of hallucination. And this is modern day Abrar in which Allah we have from the story of Surat al-Fil where they want to build something to distract people from Hajj, from Allah. So alhamdulillah, we are in a day in which we are seeing openly everything start to come very fast. For people who have eyes to see, inshaAllah, that the stories of the past become the present day events, inshaAllah.
As-salamu alaykum Sayyidi.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
How do we choose the right meditation school of thought even when guiding someone who is new to Sufism?
What does that mean? Meditation school of thought? You're asking a doctor that how to choose a doctor? You have to buy five of the books. The Naqshbandi school of thought and this entire science is nobody on the internet. If you Google muraqabah, you'll find nothing other than our post and people who posted our post and articles from that. Means that this science of muraqabah and this way of muraqabah and this encyclopedia timeless reality, that's it. That's a deep ocean in the realities of tariqah and tafakkur and contemplation. Now to think of like which school of thought I'm going to choose for somebody, then you know, that we're going to be biased towards Naqshbandi and the teachings that we are authorized to teach. If you want to find a different shaykh that teaches the muraqabah and tafakkur and has the Naqshbandi lineage and the ijazahs to teach it, then people are free to find those.
As-salamu alaykum Shaykh.
Walaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah.
Which is the last sign of Imam Mahdi's arriving?
When you see him. When the last sign is when you hear takbir and his arrival is there. And that with spiritual power they call you into their presence to bring you into that presence to take your initiation to the presence of Sayyidina Mahdi salam. But now inshaAllah is coming quicker and quicker, and all these events and all these things that are opening upon this earth. We pray that Allah dress us, bless us and protect us. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifoon, wa salaamun al mursaleen. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.
As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is Shaykh Nur John, thank you for watching the video that you're watching. InshaAllah, if you're happy with the content and happy with these programs, please support the button below, the programs that we have for our orphanage repairs, our water well, give the gift of life, our mobile food vans. We have now 5 vans, Vancouver, Chicago, Los Angeles, Pakistan. There's many programs that reach thousands of people and rescue foods and give those supplies to people in need. Your support is greatly appreciated. Also, be so kind as to leave loving comments and please share the stream. Every bit counts. As-salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.